Let's do a recap. Now, what do you know about trigonometry? When you think about it, you will think of sine, cosine, and tangent. Now, many students think of this abstractly, but what exactly are these? There are a couple of shapes in the world or in mathematics or in sciences that are very important. The circle is one of them, square, rectangle, and then, of course, there is the triangle. And of all the triangles, the most important one or the most obvious one is the right angle triangle. So it looks something like this, where it has three sides. One angle is 90 degrees. Now, this sine, cosine, and tangent simply means the ratio of two of the sides. So for example, if we are talking about this angle, the sine of this angle is the same as the ratio of the opposite side over the longest side. The triangle can take many shapes, or it can look different. It can be bigger, it can be, you know, very long, but it doesn't matter. So the sine of this angle is the ratio of the opposite side over the longer side. So cosine will be the ratio of the adjacent angle over the hypotenuse, which is the longer side, and tangent is opposite over adjacent. So this is essentially what sine, cosine, tangent means. Now, it is very clear when the angle that you are referring to is between 0 and 90 degrees. The value for sine 35 degrees will be, you can always press the calculator, but graphically it will be, you can draw a right angle triangle and say this angle is 35 degrees, for example. So 35, right angle is here. This is the adjacent side because it's beside the angle. The opposite side will be here, you know, directly opposite the angle, and this is known as the hypotenuse. So sine 35 is the length of O divided by the length of H. What happens when you want to find sine 35, but direction of the angle is here instead, 35 degrees? So by convention, we have created a way to denote the difference between this triangle and this triangle, or this angle and this angle, right? So the convention is that we will always count from the positive x-axis, and instead of saying sine 35, we will say sine of 145 degrees, because this is 145 degrees. So the difference between writing this sine 35 and this is that 35 means here, sine of 35, OA, and over here it means that you want to find the ratio of the opposite side over the hypotenuse. And these two values are the same. A better example will be the cosine. So cosine of 35 degrees is, looking at this triangle, it will be the ratio of the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. Now, what about cosine of 145 degrees? So here, it is the ratio of the adjacent side over the hypotenuse also. But the thing is that the adjacent side, if you look at this diagram or this convention, you can look at it like this. This is the xy axis, y, and this is x. So adjacent here, this length here, is a negative value, because here this is a negative value, right? This is zero, this is origin. So over here, adjacent is a negative value, and hypotenuse is always a positive value. So you will have a negative value, so negative a over h. Cosine 145 degrees is actually equals to the negative of cosine 35 degrees. So what I have written above is not the proof of anything, it just provides some intuition of what we are going to talk about. The angles of acute angles and obtuse angles. So acute angles, A-C-U-T-E, are actually angles that is between 0 and 90 degrees. And obtuse, O-B-T-U-S-E, angles are angles that is greater than 90 degrees. For example, you know, something like this. So because trigonometric functions like sine, cosine, and tangent are essentially talking about the ratio between sides of a right angle triangle. And this is not really a right angle triangle. So when we take the obtuse angle, we are actually taking this angle, you know, the acute angle of opposite obtuse side, and we are using this to generate our ratio of a right angle triangle. Sine is the ratio between the opposite side and the hypotenuse. You can see that this is when theta is between 0 and 90, the opposite side is always positive, hypotenuse is always positive, so this is a positive value. And when it is an obtuse angle, sine of this angle, let's call it another simple, we call it phi. So sine phi will be also the ratio of the opposite side over the hypotenuse. And in this case, the opposite side here, this point is a positive value, hypotenuse is also a positive value. You will have a positive value. So sine 180 degrees minus theta. Now, in the case of cosine, the cosine term, cosine theta is the adjacent side over hypotenuse, so positive over the hypotenuse. And the obtuse side will be the adjacent. Now, adjacent side is a negative value because this is the origin and it's the other side of the y-axis. Hypotenuse is a positive value, so you will have a negative of cosine 180 degrees minus theta. So you have these two identities. Now, if you take A-math, or you may be familiar with this, where they split the circle into four different segments. So depending on where your angle ends, your terminal angle ends, you will have different positive or negative values for your sine, cosine, and tangent. So the mnemonic, there are many, you know, all science teachers are crazy or whatever. This just means that all angles here are positive. This one is when the angle ends here, only sine is positive, tangent is positive, and cosine is positive. So it is really from here. So we'll talk about this in a later course, but this two cases here are really segment here one and segment two, where if you have a cosine, it will be a negative value. Okay, let's look at this example. Now say you want to find sine of CAB, this angle. Now sine is the ratio of the sides, the opposite side over hypotenuse, so it's 8 over 17. And since this is an acute angle, your answer is just 8 over 17. Now, but what happens when you want to find the sine of the obtuse angle, CAD or DAC? So this angle. Now the problem is that this is greater than 90 degrees and it's not a triangle. So by definition, you will have to look at the acute side, which is sine of CAD. And in this case, it is also 8 over 17. But the thing is that you have to decide whether there is a positive or negative side. So previously, we have already established that this is in the second segment, and sine of whatever angle in the second segment is a positive value. So this is plus. Or you can make use of the formula sine theta is the same as sine 180 degrees minus theta. To illustrate this further, let's look at cosine DAC. So I want to find the cosine of this angle. So I need to look at the acute side and the ratio of the adjacent side, because it's cosine, so it's adjacent over the hypotenuse, it's 15 over 17. But because this is 180 minus the acute side, so I have to decide whether this is plus or minus. And I have to remember that since this angle is in the second segment, only sine is positive, so over here there's a negative. So finally, let's look at tangent. Tangent of ACB. Now ACB is here, this is the angle. Tangent is the ratio between the opposite and the adjacent side. So opposite of this angle is 15 and adjacent is 8. So you need to realize that the opposite side or the adjacent side really depends on which is the angle. So the tangent of this opposite side of this angle is 15, but over here, the opposite of this angle is 8. So tangent ACB is 15 over 8, and since this is in the first segment, this will be a positive value. Let's look at this last example. Sine x is equal to 0.45. What is the value for x? X is an angle. And there's an additional information. It tells you that x is an angle that is between 0 and 180 degrees. So nothing more than that. Because from the previous examples, you know that the value for x can take on many angles. You know, you have, it can be a certain angle here, which is equivalent to another angle here, and it can even be larger than this, but this is not included in this topic. But it can either be this or this. So they want you to find out what is the value for x if x is between 0 and 180. So there is more than one answer. Now, how do you find it? You can take out a calculator, and x is equals to sine inverse of 0.45. Now, if you press the calculator, this 0.45, it will give you only one value, which is the acute angle, and the calculator will tell you that the value is 26.7 degrees. Now, for our previous example, all angles, only sine is positive. So you know that x is equal to this, or 180 degrees minus 26.7 degrees, which is equals to 153.3 degrees. So sine of either 26.7 or 153.3 will give you 0.45. Because sine of 0.45 is a positive value, you can simply do this. But what if we are talking about cosine? Cosine of x is a negative value. And if you use the same constraint, you want to find x, but x is between 0 and 180 degrees. Your answer cannot be in the first segment. It cannot be between 0 and 90 degrees. It will be here in this segment because cosine is a negative value here. So I guess this is what this example, or these two examples, is trying to illustrate. So if you were to press your calculator, x equals to cosine inverse of 0.834. You can ignore the minus sign. It's not going to give you anything. So cosine, arc cosine, or cosine inverse of 0.834, this will give you, this is 33.5 degrees. But your calculator gives you the value in the first segment. But because cosine x is a negative number, you know that it has to be here. So this is not the answer. This is inadmissible, INADM short form. So the actual answer is x equals to 180 degrees minus 33.5, which will give you 146.5 degrees. One decimal place, right? Okay, one more thing to note. This is about sine inverse and cosine inverse. Now, say you have sine inverse of x. Now, if you think that this is equals to this, you're wrong. Okay, this is very important. It is a very lousy symbol that many textbooks use. Some textbooks write it like that, ARC sign, which is a better symbol in my opinion. Because this gives you the illusion that it is this. It is really not. The definition of sine inverse is really when you have sine of a value, say sine y, and if you want to remove this, you apply another function cosine inverse, and this will give you y. So this is something that you should bear in mind. This is not equals to this. Drill it into your head.